Myself Sumit, and welcome to Let's DevOps. Today we are going to talk about how to connect to Azure using encrypted password or a secret through Azure DevOps pipeline. So before proceeding, let's first discuss why do we need this. In some custom action, it is required to connect to Azure, like creating subscription, assigning access to Azure resources, etc. To connect to Azure, we require credential, right? And keeping the raw credential in script makes it risky and vulnerable. Hence, it is best practice to make use of encrypted password or a secret. So let's follow this article, and you can find the link in the description of this video. One thing to note is this is applicable for self-hosted agent only, and if you want to learn how to configure self-hosted agent, you can follow this article. So let's follow the action list. First, we need to encrypt the password or a secret using the pipeline, and we will configure the pipeline during this course itself. Second is, like, after the encryption, we'll save the public key, and this encryption will use self-signed certificate to encrypt the password or a secret. At the end, we will decrypt that encrypted password, and then we'll connect to Azure. So now under encryption, we have step one to follow, and it is to create a test pipeline to encrypt the password or a secret. So I will use this build YAML file. So for that, you need to just click on this URL, and this will lead to this page. So I'll copy this whole content. Let's go to the article and say step two says we need to check in the downloaded YAML file into the Azure DevOps. So I'll go to that Azure DevOps under the test 0103. I'll go to this project. You can choose your respective projects also. So I'll add the file here, and I'll name it as Azure Pipelines, pipeline.yaml. You can give your own name as per your convenience. So I'll create that, and I'll paste the So now I'll commit the file. So after committing, step 3 says we need to create a YAML file, a YAML pipeline with the checked in Azure pipeline.yaml file. So we have already checked in this file. Now to create a pipeline, we need to go to the pipeline. Under the pipelines, we have this option, create pipeline. So we'll click on this, and we need to select the Azure repos kit YAML. So this will we select, and we'll just use the existing Azure pipeline YAML files because we just now we downloaded and checked in. So it is asking for path, so I'll give this YAML file because this is the one which we recently checked in. Now I'll click on continue. So let's go to the article now. So we did this, and step 4 says that once the pipeline created, make sure the update pool setting under the Azure pipeline. So here under the pool setting is the custom agent. This is my custom pool where my self-hosted agent is configured. You can just give your own pool details where you have configured your self-hosted agent. So that is about that, and then we need to run it. So let's first save it. So you can just save here, and it created with this name. So we can just edit this pipeline and go to the triggers. So you can just give some meaningful name here. So I'll say that encrypt pass or secret. Okay. And now I will just do not make a CI because we do not need. And I'll save this. So once it is saved, you will see the pipeline here. So now under the step 5, we need to run the pipeline. And before running the pipeline, you make sure you have updated the pool with your custom pool name. Okay. So now I'll go to the pipeline, and here if you see, we have created the encrypt pass secret. So I'll click on it, and then I'll run the pipeline. So once you click on run pipeline, it will ask for three user input that we need to give. One is the user ID which you need to connect to Azure, and then the password. The sales sign certificate is the name which will be created on the agent, and this is the certificate which will be used to encrypt the password. So assume that if I am going to give my user as a letsdevops@abc.net, and then my respective password is letsdevops. Self-sign certificate I can give, if any existing certificate also if you want to give, you can give. So I'll say that demo cert. Okay, and now I'll click on run. Okay, so let's go to this, and it is successful. So let's go here. So now if you see here, the password is encrypted, and there is the certificate created with the demo cert. So now let's go to the article. And step 6, on successful execution, the encrypted password will be stored on the agent machine. So in my case, I have created, I have configured my own system as an agent, and the encrypted password will be stored at this location. So I'll go to the C drive, and then credential encryption. And here, if you see, so if you see here, this is the encrypted password for the user. Let's devops@abc.net. Now coming back to the article, now this encrypted password can be used further in the pipeline execution or for your automation work. So since now we have encrypted this password and we have stored in the text file, now we can make use of that encrypted password in our DevOps organization for authentication. So one important note regarding the encrypted key is that it will only be decrypted by the agent. So if someone else gets the key, they will not be able to decrypt it. So it is very powerful. So if you want to learn more about this encryption method, you can follow this article. So now next is connect to Azure. Since we have encrypted the password, now we can use this encrypted password to connect to Azure. So the encrypted password is stored at this location. You keep the same location, or maybe you can place this credential.txt file somewhere else. So now to connect to this Azure, I will use this PowerShell code, and this I can use to configure in our pipeline. So I'll copy this complete, and then I'll go to the pipeline. I'll create a new pipeline. So assume that I say here, and I'll use the classic editor. So I'll continue, and I'll create empty. Here I need to select our self-hosted agent, so I'll give the custom agent, and I'll add a task called PowerShell. So this is just to show you how basically the pipeline will be able to decrypt the password. So now I'll use the inline, I'll place the detail here. Okay, so now if you see the PowerShell script, in the first step we are importing that the text file where it has the encrypted detail. The second is, after importing it, we are getting the username details, and then we are also decrypting the password. So under this step we are decrypting the password. So once the password is decrypted, we are creating the credential object, and then we are connecting to Azure. So I'll save this. So since I have used the dummy user, anyway it will fail. So but let me save this, and I can run that. So this will now run on our custom agent itself, and hence it will be able to decrypt the password. So now if you see, this is successful. So it means it already decrypted the password. So thanks for watching. And if you have any issue during your configuration setup, you can leave your comment here. We will be happy to help you. Have a good day.